What's up guys, Stardust CEO here. Today we've got my Utopic Evil Swarm deck. So, if you want to play Evil Swarm for some reason in 2021, then this might be the deck for you. So, we run a quite small Evil Swarm engine, and it's because these two are the only real good Evil Swarms, basically. So in order to go off with the Utopia combo, you basically need 3 level 4 monsters. Or the Ascent Sage and another monster. Now, in order to optimally quote-unquote use Evil Swarms, we run 3 Rabbit, 3 Unexpected Die, 3 Heliotrope, 3 Castor. Reforged with the army can search Castor, by the way, it's a warrior. If you didn't know, it's a warrior. Yeah. And of course, run 3 Construction and 3 Ascent Sage and a Rota for the Ascent Sage, so the chance of opening it's pretty big. Now, if you just open Unexpected Die, a normal level 4 that you can summon, and something like a Priadine, you can just go full combo. It's not that hard in this deck. Also, keep in mind, always Utopic Sage can summon the Sand Sage from the deck, which is why you only need 3 level 4s. First 2 level 4s make the Utopic Sage, and then you can just go Dragon after that and protect them too, which is really nice. We do run 1 Pegasus Twin Saber. And Dragonic Halberd as targets for the Utopia Ray. This means that even if you open your Pegasus Twin Saber, you can still summon this. One interesting thing that Evil Swarm does bring to the table is the Evil Swarm Ophion, which just requires 2 level 4 Evil L Swarm monsters. Well, it is a material of 5 rare monsters cannot be special summoned. This means no Kaijuing, no Nibiru. Although, to be fair, they're not going to summon Nibiru, but especially no Kaiju is also nice. It means they can just cheat by putting a Kaiju over your Utopia Ray. And you have certain decks that can be devastating on being able to summon high level monsters plus all these monsters in the gates, you know. Magnite, for example, will also just hate you. We don't run any search targets, you could run a single one. I just didn't think it was necessary, it's just additional inconsistency to the deck. And I read them not. So yeah, I already explained these. These are just level 4s, you can special summon. Yeah. Theoretically, you could run two Retold Fusion level 4 normal monster also. You'd have to need to find space, but you could probably kick this or this, so it's fine. I might be wondering, why do we run these? Well, we actually run a rock monster. So it might be relevant. I mean, you have a target, right? So it's possible that it can be life. I don't know, it's just... it's a rank 4 that gives you some kind of advantage before going into future Dragon, future, Utopic Future, possibly, so that's why. We run 1 Danger. I believe this was like the 40th card, so either this or an Upstart. Doesn't really do much. Theoretically, you could run the other Danger as well, the other level 4 one. But yeah. To get to Kage, if you normal summon something Boom Special, Freakstander. 3 Head Triggers, you will always control 2 level 4, so this is the third one for the full play. 3 Lightning Storms just makes it possible to go second, which is nice. Shuffle back Garnets and searches the Sun Search. The Hyper Rank Up is just one off because you can search it with the main combo, so why run multiple? I guess if you're afraid of getting ashed or something on your rank up search, you could run multiple copies, but I don't think it's necessary. At least I haven't needed it so far. 3 Imperms, yeah, just useful when going first and going second. Versatile cards are the best cards. And 3 Protect, they're just... it's just really nice in the grind game. As always, we have a certain Utopia package. Utopia Dragner, Hope Harbinger, Galaxy Ice Photon Lord, CW Dragon and Calibur, Leo Utopia Ray. Utopia Prime and Dragon Utopia are all part of this package. Their whole existence is to just end on the same board. In a hand showcase, you'll see the exact combo. This is a spell negate, but if you need an additional monster negate, you can just go for the Void and Lord and status target. Besides this, we run the Ouroboros in case you can make it. I mean, it's a possible target. Has it come up, but hey. Yeah. Ophion talked about this, very high attack as well, actually. 2550, that's pretty nice. It's more than Utopia. Doesn't require Utopia Lightning either. This just... it records materials, this extends, I mean, they're just if you're planning to just use them as materials for the F-Zeros, it's better to use these than any other rank 4, honestly, because these at least give you some kind of advantage. This summons the CS from the hand. This will revive another XCs and make it easier to go into one of these, and well, these. Just an additional monster negate that cannot be destroyed by a battle card effect. And whatever it negates, you also steal. It's basically a dragoon, almost. Not really, but it's comparable. So yeah, let's look at the hands. So yeah, we open the rescue rabbit. This gets shuffled back. The cards you didn't want to draw. Yeah. I mean, this is pretty nice. Free Ophion on top of everything. I know, I think it's nice. Pegasus. Yeah, well, I mean. Instead of just Ophion Pass, we also summon a few Monster Negates. Three. I think that's a bit better than we used to do in the past. Fourth Monster Negate, and yeah, this existing. Kind of rough for some decks. Rabbit again, Sexual Construction will be able to shuffle our rabbit back, because we only need one copy. Search Grand, rank up, just ensure we can play Grand Traps a bit better. Couldn't use the Castor here, sadly. Since you are summoning the rabbit, which is non evil swarm monster. And this is basically the most default board that you have. This is just the triple monster negate special. So construction, probably just gonna get that back. Yeah, once again, can't use the Castor here, it's the same type of deal. Although here we can go into Ophion. That's nice. Just add the extra oomph to the board. Hey, if you top deck another evil swarm, you can go to another rank for the next turn, so that's nice. That's cool. So yeah, once again, 3 monster negates and an Ophion, meaning no level 5 or higher special summons. Which can be relevant, I guess. Especially in more casual duels, if they're playing something like arm track, and yeah, good luck summoning your bosses, you can't, you literally can't. Top of all the monster negates. Kind of disgusting. But yeah, I guess the meta is definitely not relevant, but I thought it was just fun to revisit Evil Swarm, which was a control deck I actually genuinely enjoyed. But let's just say that Power Creep hasn't been nice to them. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. See you guys next time. Start signing out. Peace.